Hello friends, today we are going to talk about and learn a little of one of the classical dances of India, the Odissi dance. Odissi is one of the most graceful dances of India. It is the classical dance from the state of Odisha. Odissi has a very, very long, very old tradition. It can be traced back to almost 2000 years. The first mention of Odissi is found in Bharata's Natya Shastra as the Odra Magadhi form of dance. Most of the temples of Orissa had dance halls or Natyashalas. And one such temple, the very famous Sun Temple of Konark, has a Natyashala which abounds in a number of dance sculptures which are still found in the Odissi dance. During the 12th century, the famous Jagannath Temple at Puri was built. This became a center of art culture. In fact, life itself revolved around this temple. It had a far-reaching influence on the people. Since the 10th century, dedication of young girls to the temple for the service of the god was a common practice in almost all parts of India. In the Puri temple, these girls were called Devdasis or Maharis. The Maharis enjoyed a very high position in society. In fact, some of the queens and princesses also came to the service of the Lord and became Maharis. The Mahari tradition continued for a long time, but during the British rule, the position of the Maharis in the society declined due to lack of royal patronage. Rising costs, the Maharis were forced to live immoral lives. And after independence, there was a law banning the dedication of girls to the temples. The Maharis performed for the eyes of the god alone. The public did not view the Maharis dance. The people who were responsible for bringing this dance form to the eyes of the public were the Gotipuas. Gotipua in Oriya actually means one boy. These were little boys of the village who were dressed up as girls and they performed Odissi dance. These boys danced in the temple only during the festivals, during the Jhulan Jatra and the Chandan Jatra. But at other times, they performed in the village and they were patronized by the zamindars. In fact, many of the present-day gurus who later reconstructed the Odissi dance for the stage had been Gotipuas when they were young boys. The reconstruction of the Odissi dance began in the 50s. In the late 50s, a society called the Jayantika was formed and the gurus and scholars came together to reconstruct this dance and make it suitable for the stage. Many of the gurus who contributed towards the reconstruction of Odissi dance are Guru Pankaj Charan Das, Guru Kelu Charan Mahapatro, Guru Debo Prasad Das, Guru Mayadhar Raut, and Guru Raghunath Dattu. There were many notable scholars like Charles Fabry, like Dhirendranath Patnaik, and Mohan Khokhar, who contributed greatly to bringing Odissi before the eyes of the rest of the nation. Dancers like Indrani Rahman, Shamjukta Panigrahi, Priyamvada Mohanty, and Kumkum Mohanty brought this dance to the stage. The Nritya and Abhinay are both found in the Odissi dance. The Nritya is the pure dance, the rhythmic dance, and the Abhinay is acting in dance. Abhinay is done to Sanskrit or Oriya slokas or songs, which are spiritual in nature. In fact, the whole of the dance is spiritual in nature because it was performed in front of the god. Odissi repertoire consists of the Mangalacharan, the Botu, the Pallavi, the Sabhinay Pallavi, Abhinay, and the Mokshya. Over the years, the Odissi dance has developed its own vocabulary. It has its own set of head movements, eye movements, neck movements, torso movements, hand gestures, feet positions, its bhangis or postures, its walks and gaits, its jumps, turns and spins. When we start learning the dance, we first learn these ABCDs of the Odissi dance. But before I go on to the dance, I would like to introduce you to two of the students who are going to learn the dance with you. We have with us Oli and Bindi. And we have Kishorda accompanying us on the Pakhavaj. So we go on to learn the dance. But before we learn the dance, we have to do the Bhumi Pranam, or the salutation to the Mother Earth. Now, why do we do the Bhumi Pranam? We do the Bhumi Pranam because we are going to stamp our feet on the earth and dance on it. So we say that we are sorry, we apologize for dancing and stamping on the earth. We show our respect to Mother Earth before we start dancing. We do the Bhumi Pranam. I'll show it once and then you will do it with me. Now we'll do it very slowly, one by one, one step at a time. Keep your hands joined. One, two, three, start. One, stamp your right. Okay, keep those elbows down, down, and turn your palms outward. Now go forward with your right. Two, three, join your feet and hands. Now open your feet out, lift your heels and sit. Four, five, touch the ground, bring your hands up and stand up at the same time. Now go back with your right, take your left and one. Okay? Now you do it by yourselves. Now, before we start dancing, we have to do some exercises so that you don't hurt yourselves. You have to flex your joints before you start any kind of dance. So there are some exercises which are peculiar to the Odissi dance. First, you keep your heels together and feet apart. Hold your hands like this. Now, in one, two, three, four, you sit, and in one, two, three, four, you stand. Ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni. Okay, this is exercise number one. The things that you have to be careful about, you have to keep your feet open, fully keep your toes to the sides. Okay, when you sit, don't lift your heels. Keep your heels firmly on the floor and try not to bend forward. I know that is difficult, but you must try not to bend forward. Go down as much as you can without bending forward. Once you start bending forward, then don't go down. Then it is of no use if you're bending forward. Then you get up again. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, ti, na, little more. Ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ta, ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, bend more, na, ka, bend more. Ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni. Okay, this is exercise number one. Now we go into exercise number two, which is almost the same thing, but when you go down, you lift your heels and you go down. Okay, and keep your hands like this. And then you get up again. And when you get up, make sure that your feet are apart, your toes are to the sides. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, slowly. Na, ka, ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni. Okay, ta. This is exercise number two. Now the third exercise is that you go up on your toes like this as far as you can. Then you come down and go back on your heels. Again on your toes and on your heels. Okay? Keep your hands on the waist. In the Odissi dance, we make a Shikhara Mudra. And we touch this part and this on the waist. Place it like this. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni. Ta, go down slowly, flat on the ground. Now, na, on your heels. No, you have to lift on. You have to be on your heels. Okay? Once more. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti. Stay there. Ta, get down slowly. Ta, flat on the ground. Na, ka, now lift your toes. Ti, ni, ta, on the flat, on flat on the ground again. Na, get up on your toes. Ta, ta, ti on your heels, na, ka, ti, ni, and ta. Okay. So, that is number three. Now, for number four, you keep one knee flexed and you make both straight again. Then you flex another and make both straight again. Okay? One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti. Okay, now when you're doing it, you're putting all your weight and you're moving your hips like this. But you don't move your hips, just flex your knees and straight and with a jerk. So you don't move anything else. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni, ta, ta, ti, na, ka, ti, ni, ta. So, we've done four exercises so far. Now, these exercises are silent exercises. You don't make any sound with your feet. Now, what we will do is we'll do four of the sound exercises. Now you keep your toes apart, lift your heels, and sit like this. Okay? Now we will jump, lifting the whole thing up from the floor. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni. Continue. Ta, ta, thi, na. Okay, now get up. Now keep your hands on the waist and you will jump, bringing, folding your, from the knees you fold your legs up like this. Okay, so if I turn back, it is like this. Okay, one, two, three, start. Ta, ta. Thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta. Okay. This is the second of the sound exercises. The third one is also similar. You will lift one foot at a time and bring it down. One foot and bring it down like this. You bring it down like this and bring it down like this. Okay. One, two, three, start. Ta, ta, ki, na. Thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta. Okay. Now you have done exercises for your ankles, for your knees. Now we bend the waist, from the waist. Keep your hands up like this. Hold it here. So now what we do? We stamp the right and we bend to the right. And stamp the left and bend to the left. Okay? As far as you can from the waist. One, two, three, start. One, the thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi. Okay, so you keep your hands, don't let your hands come forward. Keep your hands right in line with your ears and you bend straight from the waist. Okay, one, two, three, start. Ta, ta, thi, na, ka, thi, ni, ta. Okay, now we have done the warm up, so we are ready for the dance. We go into the dance vocabulary. The first thing that we do is the head movements. The first head movement is sama. Sama means keeping your head straight and looking straight. Now we use this for a number of things. We are trying to look in front. So we use the sama head movement. Also, to show pride, we use the head movement of sama. Now then, to show, we are just starting meditation. We want to go into meditation. So we look in front. Then to show someone who is blank, who does not have an expression on his face, we use the sama head position. So we do the sama. Show me the sama position. Yeah, straight. The next thing that we do is the Udvahita. Udvahita is you have your head up like this, Udvahita. This, as you can understand, is used for looking at anything that is high, okay? Say, looking at the sky. Look at the sky, you look up. Looking at a flag, you look up. Looking at the mountains, high up, okay? So we do the Udvahita. Yeah, keep your head more up. Yeah, this is Udvahita. The next is Adhomukha, which is down. And we use this for when you're showing that, showing shame, for instance. You're showing someone who's ashamed. You look down. Also, you're showing someone who is worried and thinking, looking down. Okay? So we do the Adhomukha. Adhomukha. Okay. Now we do the Alolita. Alolita is rotating your head. This is Alolita. Alolita is also used for a number of things. For showing sleepiness, you can use Alolita. For showing intoxication, you can use Alolita. Okay? Do the Alolita. Down, side, back, side, and down. Again from the other side. Okay. Now we go into the next one, which is Dhuta. Dhuta is looking sideways. Okay? This is used for looking at anything that is to the sides. That is one thing. Also for saying no. Okay? Dhuta. Then we have Kampita, which is up and down. This is Kampita. Kampita is used for a number of things, like saying stop. Or asking a question, okay? Also for calling someone, come here. Kampita, this is the Kampita Shir. Then we have Parabritta, looking back. Parabritta is used for looking back. So let's do Parabritta. Okay, so you have to make a distinction between Dhuta, which is looking sideways, and Parabritta, which is looking back. Okay, you can also use it for, say, tying your hair, making a hairdo. Okay, so do that again. Parabritta, looking back, without moving your shoulders. Don't move your shoulders, just look back with your head. Utkhipta. So Utkhipta, I want to say, Oli, go there, okay? Bindi, follow her. That is for Utkhipta. Do that, Utkhipta. Then we have Parivahita, which is a side-to-side movement. You can use this for judging something. Let's look at Bindi. Is she nice? I'm approving of Bindi. Okay? That is how you use the Parabritta. Sorry, Parivahita. Okay, now we will do all of them one by one. Sama, straight. Udvahita. Adhomukha, down. Now rotate. This is Alolita. Now sideways, Dhuta. kampita. Now look back, parabritta, the other side, utkipta and parivahita. Now you will do it by yourself and say each one before doing it, okay? One, two, three, start.
Samam.
Udvahita. Adhomukha. Now rotate slowly. Alolita. Alolita. Yeah. See that you don't rotate your body. Now you are doing the head movements. So rotate only your head. Okay? Yeah, only your head. Okay. Then you have to go back more when you're going back. So here and you go here and go back fully. Alolita. Then dhuta sideways. Then kampita. Up and down. Kampita. Then paravritta. Paravritta. Turn back, look back. Slowly. The other side. Then utkshipta. And parivahita. Side to side. Parivahita. Okay. So these were the head movements. One very important thing to remember is that when you start the dance, you do it with the Bhumi Pranam. Also, when you end the dance, you do the Bhumi Pranam once more. I would like to end today's episode with the Bhumi Pranam.